All right, guys, another edition of Let's Watch Sports. We're going to have a nice game right here of Green Bay versus Atlanta. For those that are Cowboys fans, I'm sorry you guys couldn't finish that one off. You guys had a nice season there with your two rookies. And best of luck to you guys next year. But here we go. We're going to have Green Bay and Atlanta. Potentially, actually no, it is the last game in the Georgia Dome. And if I had to take a guess, after how they both played last week, Atlanta was on fire against the Legion of Boom. And Green Bay also was on fire last week. But I'm going to give it to the home team. I'm going to pick Atlanta to win in a shootout, kind of like Dallas and Green Bay last week. If I had to take an exact guess on a score, I would say pretty close to like how Dallas Green Bay's score was, like 34-35. No, it wasn't like that. It was 31-34. I'll see this one will be like 45-48 Atlanta. But you never know. It could be a low scoring game. But I'll talk to you guys after this game. Enjoy.
Defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon.
Well, it wasn't exactly home cooking, but being back in the area against Dallas did nothing to diminish Ty Montgomery's enthusiasm for playing against the Cowboys. Had two touchdowns in that game and his return back to his home area.
You're exactly right, from Dallas. Played at Stanford, but he is a boy from the Big D. Had to feel good to hit pay dirt twice and get the win.
And how about what he's done this season? A receiver, kick returner, now the primary ball carrier as a running back. It'll be interesting to see what they do with him in 2017.
A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
He's able to get this one down to about the 40. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
On second down, here's Rodgers. And he's going to go out of bounds at the 30-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And some room to maneuver. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
Let's just go ahead and state the obvious. You're going to want a big game out of that guy. Big time run to get things started. But even more importantly, coming in on the road, trying to silence the crowd, take them out of it a little bit, slow down the emotions of the game, and get yourselves under control and feel like, yeah, we're going to be okay on the road.
And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Rodgers to throw on second down. Looking for someone to throw to. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
He's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. A nickelback added defensively as they look to stop this third and 8. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Finding time. He's got his target. It's Cobb. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up the first down.
Rodgers going to throw. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now this will be the 9th play on this drive. Rodgers to throw once more. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams from 3 yards out. And the Packers take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. Well, that's how they envisioned it. Get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Here's Eric Weems now on the return. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And as Atlanta gets set to go again on the offensive side, you know, before the game, you and I talking about the Georgia Dome. Surprisingly getting one more game in front of those home fans thanks to Green Bay's win over Dallas.
Yeah, I don't think they truly expected it, you know, and that's one of those added bonuses, right? You get one more in front of the home fans, one more time with your routine at home as you play the most important game of the season, the NFC Championship game. But I do know this, our colleague Ulysses, no one happier than him to have one more game in the Dome, as he is a monster Falcons fan.
Falcons hoping to make their second Super Bowl. They lost in Super Bowl 33 to Denver. Well, there they went blitz defensively, Charles, and things were paved well coming from the linebacker position.
I love the way that you described it, paved well. Oftentimes, the guy who gets home on the blitz, he's going to get all the credit, but his teammates did all the dirty work, right? They ran into people on purpose. They sometimes tugged on jerseys to hold linemen to create space and gaps. And that play finished off really, really well. Well conceived, well designed, and even better executed.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. On third down, Ryan. He's got time in the pocket. Great protection. He's got Sanu. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because, you know, those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
On second down, Freeman. It'll be a gain of 7, and they get it back to a 3rd and 3.
Brandon, I remember going through the draft process last year, and one of the things I liked so much about Ezekiel Elliott of the Cowboys was how hard he played when he didn't have the football in his hands. And then I thought back to myself, that's Devontae Freeman. He can do it all. Run it, catch it, block. You name it, he does it, and he does it at a really big-time pace.
Quite a tandem with Tevin Coleman. They combined for 102 rushing yards against Seattle, also 102 receiving yards. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
The goal of every offense is to move the chains, pick up first downs. A nice job finding an open receiver for a completion.
Zone now. Here's Ryan on first down. He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
So we've got a second and five. To the running game. It's Freeman. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
That was a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Here, Tevin Coleman. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them, but on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Coleman. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Tevin Coleman taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Now Matt Bryant on for the point after. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Rodgers. He's got a man complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Complete left side, the tight end Rodgers. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
They come out here in the eye. Now Starks. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter about to get underway with the Packers in possession of the football. So they're operating in the red zone. So the chain gang now done for the drive. Ball on the 10, first and goal. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Partner, when it's a goal-to-go situation, if you're on the field on defense, you have to know that you may be called on to make a tackle at any time. Here, the cornerback does exactly that. Plays the run really well and makes a big play.
Second down, here's Rodgers. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Rodgers now on third and goal, surveying the field, all kinds of time. And probably the wise decision there, no one open, he just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And Crosby puts it through, and they take the lead here now at 10-7. And that field goal right there should probably feel pretty easy and not much pressure for Mason Crosby given the two kicks he had to beat Dallas.
Look, when you talk about Mason Crosby and you go back in his career, remember he kicked at the University of Colorado, which meant he was kicking at altitude in his home games, which added an extra you-know-what to his field goal range. I did one of his college games, and late in the game, the team that they were playing against scored and went ahead. And I said, don't kick it short and give Mason Crosby a chance. He ended up kicking a 47-yard field goal to win it. That would have been good at 67.
Yeah, the two field goals over 50 yards. First time that he's ever hit 250-plus yarders. He picked a good time to do it. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, give up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully. One of the beauties of a 3-4 defense is that you have flexibility with your linebackers and you can put them in different spots. But one of the downsides is an offensive team that's committed to running the football, you can get your big offensive linemen up on linebackers quicker, and that usually gives you an advantage in running it.
So second and eight here after the penalty. Now Ryan on second down. It's caught over the middle. Hooper. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. From the gun on third down, Ryan. He's got time. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Yeah, that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. He lost 4 there, and it's third down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Finding time. And this is going to be incomplete. Jeff Janis, the one he was looking for. And that brings up fourth down.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
That's taken on the 25.
Whoosh.
21 yards. Well done on the return. And it'll be Falcon football as they take possession. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Give the tackle there to Morgan Burnett.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
So second and medium, second and 5 now. Freeman again. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. And Charles, this infraction is going to be against the offense. False start.
Sometimes you have to get up to the line of scrimmage, make sure your team is set before you begin your cadence.
Shotgun, Ryan. Hits his target. It's Taylor Gabriel. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 24 that time. And it'll give the Falcons a first down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
It's Freeman, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
The evolution of Clay Matthews as a player, it's just one that they're going to end up writing books about. He didn't even start until his senior year at USC. He didn't start in high school, and now he's at all-pro level in the NFL. How about the play he just made there?
Yeah, he has certainly made a name for himself. William Clay Matthews III. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Third down now following the completed pass. Third down, Ryan. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Down here in the red zone, you know your tight end's going to be a favorite target. Couldn't hang on.
And sometimes they just have to get out of their own head because they understand how tight windows are there and how many bodies are there. And sometimes they just overthink it and don't catch the ball.
And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through, and that will knot us up at 10. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be fielded at the 6. Oh, a little 360.
Oh,
and he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here on first down. Caught left side by Cobb. A very solid gain of 27. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And he's brought down. 18 yards on the pickup there. And now every time I see Jared Cook catch a ball, what am I thinking of? The catch.
The catch against Dallas. And look, Green Bay's had a lot of incredible catches and plays over the years. That one will be forever etched in the minds of Packers Nation.
And he's not a rookie. He's been in the league for a little while. But is that his coming out party or what? Because the whole league fans know who he is now and what a play he made to help Green Bay move on to the NFC Championship game.
And he'll go down at the 28. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they do.
Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. It's brought in by Janis. The completion good for three, and it's second down. To throw on second down. That's complete right around the 8. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Randall Cobb, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Packers have moved out in front. Extra point try now for Crosby. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17 to 10. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Ryan, and finding the tight end Hooper. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. He's got time in the pocket. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
And now a first down following that long gain. Now Ryan on first down. Complete over the middle to Hardy. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And now the offense operates in the red zone. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. And this is Gabriel on the catch. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Tying the football game. And the ref goes under the hood, puts the heads. So the challenge comes in inside of 2 minutes, and it gets overturned.
And it changes the whole format of what's about to happen because both sides had thought a certain call had been made. Now they have to flip back and start over.
Call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal. And they're going to speed things up here. Now Ryan on second down. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
The defensive coordinator came into this game with a plan to get to the quarterback with whatever type of pressure is necessary. It's working to perfection for him today.
This could very well be four down territory, but right now we focus on third and goal from the one. On third and one, Ryan. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
On third and one, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there, but they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
The Falcons will call on Matt Bryant for the field goal try. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And Bryant's kick is good. And that will cut this lead back down to four now. It's 17-13. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
They go with a running back, and he'll take this one up to about the 23. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching. And now, due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. Fielded about a yard deep, and he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Second down following the run. Again, they'll run with Freeman. What a spin. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well in the first go-round. They want to throw the football like crazy. But the way to open up throwing the ball is to run it. And they've run it well here to start the second half.
And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
And that's why you see so many teams play a 3-4 defense, because that set gives you a lot of flexibility about where to bring pressure from, and it's hard for an offense to pick it up. Left side, right side, up the middle, especially with some really flexible linebackers.
This is Coleman. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone, but these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
On 3rd down, Ryan. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. Here's Matt Bosher now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this will be taken at the 13. A very good return that time. 18 yards, and it'll be Packer football here. 1st down and 10. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah, defense, we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. They come out here in the eye. Rodgers to throw on 2nd down. Surveying the field. He sets to it's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Packers add on to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his 2nd touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. And this one through the uprights and good. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
They'll try to get the ground game going with Freeman. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a pickup of 14 there, and the Falcons are going to get a first.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Freeman again, a first down carry. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Ryan leaves with Freeman on the draw. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick-hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
So 3rd and 7 and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Ryan, he's going to go for a big play downfield. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And now it's 4th down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
On 1st and 10, here's Rodgers. Caught left side by Cobb. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game at Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Well, let's take a quick pivot here, and I want to ask you about the Kansas City game against Pittsburgh. I certainly didn't see 6 field goals winning that. No touchdowns for the Steelers. That was an interesting affair.
It really was, and while Pittsburgh never got into the end zone, found a way to win it with 6 field goals, Kansas City did get into the end zone, but not at the time that they flat out needed to. So both of these teams were exhibiting that bend but don't break mentality on defense. And Pittsburgh, with the help of a holding call on a 2-point conversion, tied the ball game for Kansas City, took that off the board. Pittsburgh able to escape and head to an AFC Championship game showdown with New England.
And you had a very good succinct quote to me. You said 6 field goals will not beat New England.
Not a chance in heck does 6 field goals beat New England. They've got to find a way to turn those into touchdowns.
Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
On second down, here's Rodgers. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
Give it to him right up the gut. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. A gain of 3, 2nd down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Now Rodgers throwing on 2nd down. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down. The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. 3 receivers to the left, 1 to the right. Rodgers going to try and throw on 3rd down. And that is incomplete. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver. And it's now 4th and 3. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, 3rd quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And Crosby puts it through, and that will get the lead up to 14. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
On 2nd down, Ryan. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got
on 1st down, Ryan. He completes it to Julio Jones. 11 yards for number 11. And until that point, we haven't seen Julio Jones. That's hard to believe here this late in the game.
And no one more frustrated than Julio Jones, because Receivers feed off of catches. That's their fuel, and that's also their affirmation. And he hasn't been getting much of that in this game, and their team is losing, and he wants to have a better effect on the game.
Just the first connection, Ryan to Jones there. Now Ryan. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Throwing again, Ryan. His throw incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And it's third down. The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down. On third down, Ryan. He's got time. Ryan hit. Football.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
It's brought in by Janice. And they finally take him down, but not before he reaches the 43. It's a big play there for Green Bay. And even 40 yards. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. And look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited, because you can plan for a running game all you want and want to press that advantage when you get it. But for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now, they've got to keep that going, want to continue to grind out the clock, because it's definitely in their favor at this stage of the game. Can they close the game out and continue to do exactly what we just saw there, and that's run the football?
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
It's really come into vogue to talk about the different gaps that the defense tries to attack in an offensive line. And most of the time we're talking about blitzes. How many times have you heard double A-gap blitz? Well, where is the A-gap? It's the space between the center and the guards either side. So when you're having a double A gap blitz, that's two guys coming through that gap. In this situation, though, that A
blitz coming and down he goes. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Can't find anyone open. And complete right side to Cook. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish, because strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
Throwing is Rodgers, and incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
Now Mason Crosby for the Packers' field goal try. This to make it a 3-score game late. And Crosby puts it through, and that'll push the lead up to 17. And you figure with that, this game's pretty well out of reach.
It would take a heck of a comeback at this point. Being 3 scores down, I think that's too much to ask with time winding down here in the fourth.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. Here's Weems to return. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Second and 10, it's Ryan. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. A good pickup there, a 22. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. First down. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Ryan will throw again. Quick throw, that's complete on the inside slant. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball, but when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
First and 10, it's Ryan. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. They'll get 23 yards there. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Tevin Coleman with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Falcons get a bit closer. He's doing his part, but still facing a sizable deficit.
And he would like to do more, but he needs help from the other two-thirds, right? He needs his defense to bow up a little bit, and he also needs special teams to maybe create some big plays and help them get back in it.
Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers hands team. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. Oh, for a second there, I had flashbacks to a few years ago, the NFC Championship game for the Packers, but here they're able to hold on.
And many things changed in Green Bay after that game. Personnel, people coaching, the whole deal. And in this case, they get it done. No fail like they had in Seattle.
And they give this time to the tailback. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40. On the tackle that time, Tyson Jackson. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Eight yards to go here on second down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he will be stopped here for no gain, and that is going to take us to the two-minute warning. And on the tackle, Jonathan Babineau. To gain is the 33 on third down. And they'll go with a ground attack here. It'll be a minimum pickup, and it will take us to the two-minute warning. And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll run it now out of the gun. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs.
319!
Rodgers looking to throw. Finding time. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Rodgers to throw. He's got time in the pocket. Caught left side by Cobb. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. For the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. 3 yards won't be enough here, as that'll bring up fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And Crosby puts it through, and that will extend their lead even further. So they settle for just the 3 there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the 4th.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the 5.
All right, well,
but 3 does give them some breathing room and lets them build up.
That's a deficit. I don't think Atlanta will come back in with 50 seconds, no timeouts. That was an exciting game. In the beginning, it was very close, and then Green Bay just started pulling away. But, it looks like they will be your NFC champions, the Green Bay Packers, to represent the NFC in Super Bowl 51. But, you never know. My simulation was wrong last week about, what team was it wrong about? Now I forget. I had one wrong. I forget which one I got wrong. Now I gotta look. Now it's gonna bug me. It was an NFC match. I think it was Seattle and Atlanta I got wrong last week. Yeah, Seattle in my simulation won, but in reality they didn't. So, you never know.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments.
Yeah, they definitely did not win this game, Atlanta. But they still had a good game. The running backs did at least. Matty Ice threw no touchdown passes, but did throw a lot of yards this game. Well, I'll let this game finish out the last 30 seconds, just in case they score again. I like to get the official final score at the end of the game. And Rodgers had a field day against Atlanta's defense. I think he had, what, he had like 3 passing touchdowns, I think? He had a top-notch game, that's for sure. Oh, wow. Usually you throw it away at the Julio, he gets it all day. Actually, if he caught that, he didn't run for a touchdown. That would probably would have sealed the deal pretty much. 4th and 2, they got to go for it.
They're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it.
This is a fun game all around to watch. Not bad losing by 13, really. Could be a lot worse. Hey, you got the first. And you got a bounce. Hey, you never know. They might get a touchdown. It might be a 27-33 final score.
Big time throw on 4th.
Now that had to feel good, didn't it? Taking that type of a gamble there.
And if I remember, I don't fully watch. Well, I do fully watch, but I don't pay attention to who catches what. I don't think I've seen Julio catch a pass at all, unless I missed it. I thought that was him for a second. I saw the 1. I was like, don't tell me. Right when I say I haven't seen him catch anything, he just caught it.
And now they're in the hurry up.
Spike it and Hail Mary it, dude. Hail Mary that shit.
Spike here with 7 seconds left on the clock. And here comes play number six on this drive. One receiver left, three to the right.
Looks like Hail Mary. I'd just throw to Julio at this point. If I was doing a Hail Mary, I'd just be like, all right, Julio, it's going to you, man.
Look at the time. He's going to let it fly.
Did he catch that? Did he fucking catch that? That was crazy. The game's over, but that was fucking crazy catch. Holy shit. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed that. That was a crazy way to end it, even though they lost, but that was awesome. All right, I'll see you guys all in the AFC Championship Simulation. Hope you all enjoyed that. Good luck to Green Bay and Atlanta. See you on the next one.